फिजिक्स क्लास 12 चैप्टर 5 मैग्नेटिज्म एंड मैटर। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डन हिस्टेरेसिस कर्व। टुडे वी शैल डू परमानेंट मैग्नेट्स एंड इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट्स। फर्स्ट वी डू परमानेंट मैग्नेट्स। सब्सटेंस विच एट रूम टेम्परेचर रिटेन द फेरोमैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टी फॉर अ लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ टाइम आर कॉल्ड परमानेंट मैग्नेट्स। दैट मीन्स दे विल बी नॉट इजिली डीमैग्नेटाइज, दे विल बी कॉल्ड परमानेंट मैग्नेट्स। We have got how to make the permanent magnet. Okay, in our textbook they have mentioned three ways. First, hold an iron rod in north to south direction and hammer it repeatedly. Second, hold a steel rod and stroke it with one end of bar magnet number of times. More or less the same both are. Third one, place a ferromagnetic rod in a solenoid and pass a current. So these are the three ways. And we have got, if we are going to select the material for a permanent magnet, it should have some properties, okay? And the properties will be the material with high retentivity so that the magnet is strong. So you should have a material with high retentivity, then high coercivity so that magnetization is not erased, and high permeability. So you are, if you are selecting a material for permanent magnet, you should have, material should have high retentivity, high coercivity and high permeability. The examples you can take is steel, alnico, cobalt steel, tikonal. These are the examples of the material with these conditions. Then next is electromagnets. Electromagnets get easily magnetized and demagnetized. So they are the materials or they are the magnets which will be easily magnetized, demagnetized, like how we did for the hysteresis curve. The core of electromagnets are made of ferromagnetic material of high permeability and low retentivity. The material for electromagnet which we select will be having high permeability and low retentivity. The example is soft iron. The uses, it has got some uses. It is used in transformer cores, telephone diaphragms, electric bells, cranes to lift machineries, loudspeakers. And how these electromagnets are made? See, if you have a solenoid, place the soft iron in this, okay? Or when you place the soft iron here and apply the current, then it will get magnetized. But when you switch off, it will again demagnetized. In placing soft iron rod in a solenoid and passing current increases magnetization, okay? So when you place, it will increase the magnetization. Then, and switching off current, the magnetization is switched off, as soft iron have low retentivity. The hysteresis curve of such material must be narrow. Okay, I was telling you that this area should be narrow. Okay, this area should be narrow. The energy dissipated and the heating will consequently small. Now, if the hysteresis curve is narrow, if this part is narrow, okay, then we know that energy loss gives you the area of the loop. So, if this is less, that means energy loss is less, and that means the heating material, heating effect also will be less. Okay, so we can say the energy dissipated means loss, and the heating will consequently small. So, energy loss will be less, and it will be not heated up fast. Okay, or it will not heated up more. The material must have high resistivity to lower eddy current losses, and the material which you are using should have resistivity to lower eddy currents. Okay, so this is about permanent magnet and ferromagnet, and this is the last topic in your chapter. So we complete chapter 5, magnetism and matter, with this. Thank you very much.